All right, Eternal Life fans, it's me, Rowan, your friendly neighborhood Eternal Life fan. We need to talk about GMOs. We need to have a serious discussion about this, okay? What we eat is a big deal. This is our health. So I've been doing some research about GMOs, and now it is time for me to share with you all some of my recent findings. So while researching this topic, I came across this website called responsibletechnology.org. The link will be in the description. It's the Institute for Responsible Technology, and they claim to have the most comprehensive source of GMO health information on the web, anywhere. And this organization is created by Jeffrey Smith. This guy has clearly done the most in-depth research on this topic of GMOs. And personally, I'm thankful to him for doing so much of the research. He's really put in a lot of work. So in a recent interview published on December 1st, Jeffrey said, "The entire promotion and approval of GMOs in the United States was based on fraud and political collusion." So that is quite a statement to make, but Jeffrey does a good job of supporting it. When the FDA looked into GMOs in 1992, they concluded that GMO crops are substantially equivalent to non-GMO crops. Now, this is from Monsanto's own website here. You can find this information all across the internet. Substantially equivalent. The question is, who really had the power to speak on behalf of all of the scientists at the FDA and make this conclusion? The answer to this question should make us angry. It makes me angry. A man who, just 2 years after he left the FDA, was vice president at Monsanto, the former vice president at Monsanto, he's calling the shots here. Okay, you know the company that has profited billions by promoting GMOs? That man is Michael Taylor. Okay, I've linked to his Wikipedia page. You can verify all these facts. So do you see some potential for corruption here? Some conflict of interest? This is the same guy. While at the FDA, he determined that milk from cows treated with bovine growth hormone did not have to be labeled. Bovine growth hormone, BGH, for those who don't know, is another one of Monsanto's products. Okay, it's injected into cows so they produce more milk, and it leaves the milk less nutritious. And it increases the cancer risk in those who ingest it. All right, but getting back to the scientists at the FDA, here's what I found out. So this Mr. Taylor guy, okay, he's the one who gave the green light on GMOs, saying they're safe and there's no difference. There's no difference between the GMOs and the non-GMOs. Okay, there was a lawsuit. There was a lawsuit filed that forced out a lot of hidden information. Okay, including findings by scientists at the FDA. Now, here's what I want you to grasp here. Okay, what we have here is the FDA, the scientists here, they're being paid by public tax dollars. So yeah, of course, why shouldn't their work be hidden away where no actual citizens will be able to, you know, find the study and learn about it and what those scientists had to say directly? This is insane. Why all the red tape? Why are they hiding stuff from us? So these findings, these hidden findings by the scientists at the FDA, they showed a lot of disagreement on GMOs. Yeah, this was not a unanimous decision that GMOs are substantially equivalent to normal food. No. What we found here in these hidden studies was that there was a lot of differences discovered between the GMO and the non-GMO. And, but the FDA, they apparently didn't want us to know. And what a shocker. Yeah, maybe they don't want us to know because if we knew, then we might actually want to avoid these GMOs. Hey, by all means, go and eat GMOs if you want to make yourself a guinea pig, whatever. You know, I'm not going to be a guinea pig. I'm into being better safe than sorry. But anyways, back to Jeffrey Smith. Here's some other interesting stuff he found. He was asking people what they noticed when they stopped eating GMOs. And consistently, okay, he found reports of people with When they stopped eating GMOs, they had less gastrointestinal upset, less brain fog, and all kinds of other benefits when they stopped eating the GMOs. Here's a little clip from a documentary that he was recently featured in talking about this issue.
When I made the film Genetic Roulette, it was my third film, but it was the first feature length. And as I was touring with it, I had the idea to start asking audiences how many people noticed an improvement in their health when they switched to non-GMO food. And a tremendous number were raising their hand at this point. And I'd say, okay, what did you notice? What kind of improvements? And the number one condition was always gastrointestinal. The number two was always increased energy and reduced brain fog. Number three or so was reduced weight gain. And then there was headaches, anxiety, skin conditions, allergies, asthma, autoimmune disease, a whole host of things. In fact, there were like three dozen different ones that I came across, but some so reliable in every single lecture, it became predictable. And I even sent out a survey and got 3,600 people who said that they improved from switching to a non-GMO diet. And it was the same order that I had seen in 150 lectures.
And then beyond all of that, there is the cases involving livestock and what happens when you feed the cows GMO versus non-GMO. And a lot of farmers found that there was significant health improvements when they fed their cows non-GMO. After looking at all the evidence here, it seems clear to me that smart, intelligent Eternal Life fans would avoid these GMOs. Better safe than sorry. That is the key. That is a good motto to live by.